When I said I wanted to win 8 gold medals, basically half the people in the swimming world thought I was absolutely crazy and nobody could ever do something like that. But for me, I was somebody who believed in it and somebody who believed in the process of getting there. I knew it wasn't going to happen overnight, like I said before. But every little small thing that we did was a small stepping stone in order to be, even be able to have that chance and that opportunity to do what I did in 2008. So, you know, when I say from 2002 to 2008 was basically trial and error. So for me, in 2002, that's really when I started amping up my event schedule, where I was swimming 4 to 5 individual events and having a couple relays at Pan Pacs, World Championships, major international competitions throughout that time frame. Because at that time, at the Olympic Games, that's where I think the real truth comes out. Because I think there are a lot of people who are very talented who can make it there. There are very few people who can deal with the pressure and the stress that happens when we're there. So that's why I say we had to make sure that we were physically, emotionally, and mentally ready, because I had to be ready to be able to kind of manage my emotions through that week. Yeah, winning a gold medal is absolutely incredible. There's nothing better than standing on a podium listening to your national anthem play after you had just won a gold medal. But for me, I'm somebody who I knew that I had 7 other events after the first day. So I have to throw that in the back of my head. I got to throw that race out. Even though in 08, I broke world record, won my first gold medal. Like, I was like, cool, like things are starting really well. So I have to put that behind me to then get ready for the next race. And on top of that, I have to make sure I'm eating the right amount, I'm sleeping the right amount, my body is as fresh as I can possibly be. So that means sitting in an ice tank, getting massages, getting stretched, all of these small things that end up adding up to major end result. And that was something that we learned through that process. So for us, we always also tried to compare. Every day is a new challenge, right? Every day is a challenge, a day that we can prepare ourselves even more. So for us, we would call it putting money into the bank. So at the end of the year, when we had a major international competition, we could withdraw that money that we had saved throughout the year. And look, I'll be the first one to tell you, there were a lot of days where I did not want to get out of bed. And I guarantee you, if I ask the question here, if everybody is excited to get out of bed every single day, if I saw a hand, I'm going to blatantly call you a liar. Because we all know that is far from the truth. But if you have those little small goals, those little small things that get you excited when you don't want to, it's gonna make it even better and even easier at the end when you're getting ready for a presentation or the end of the year or this or that, whatever event you're leading up to, it's gonna make it so much easier. And I think if you look at the greats in anything in any walk of life, the greats do things when they don't always want to. And that's the separation. For me, that's what I've found. Because I can sure as hell tell you that there were days where I hated my coach. There were days where we got in fights, we got in arguments, we couldn't stand what we were doing. I would do things purposely to piss him off, but that's a different story. But, you know, I think that was just really how we worked. Like, he was somebody who was so perfect for me that if I ever swam for anybody else, I never would have had the chance to do what I did, because he challenged me in ways and forced my mind to think differently. You know, for me as a kid growing up, I'm huge into music, and music is a big part of my life. And I'm a huge Biggie Smalls fan, and he wrote a song called "The Sky Is the Limit." And as a kid growing up, I believed that. I believed that whatever I put my mind to, and if I was willing to make sacrifices and I was dedicated, that I could achieve absolutely anything.
You still do.
I still do.